जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी। गोपी जना वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी, जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी। गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी, जय राधा माधवा कुंज विहारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, कृष्णा कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे हरे, कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जय जगन्नाथ जय बल देवा जय सुभद्रा राधा कृष्ण चंद्र राधा कृष्ण चंद्र राधा कृष्ण चंद्र राधे राधा माधव राधा माधव राधे निताय गौरंग जय निताय गौरंग निताय गौरंग जय निताय गौरंग गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्य गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल कलयुग पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की श्रील प्रभुपाद की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च नमावों विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा वी वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज ऑफ इस्कॉन कल्चरल सेंटर साउथ बैंगलोर फॉर दिस मॉर्निंग श्रीमद् भागवतम क्लास ऑन Sunday morning. I have been getting the good fortune of associating with all of you regularly. having opportunity to glorify Krishna. In the previous session, I had begun with how Lord Krishna is all attractive. Our whole class we devoted on that. Although the topic was attracting the all attractive. So I had said that I will continue that session and complete it today. How to attract the all attractive Krishna. Because Krishna is all attractive, he does not lack in anything. How can we attract him? Generally in this world, somebody attracts another person who is lacking something. See, somebody is hungry, then a man who has money can attract him. And then he can attract him and give him food. Somebody is thirsty, you can attract him and give him a bottle of water. Somebody requires a recommendation to admit a student in a college, and you are a big politician in power and you have the power to recommend, then people will queue up. They will line up to beg you for a favor. In this world, people make friendships with the desire to gain favors from others or to get support to face their enemies. People make allies to connect with so that they can face their enemies. Or people seek favors when they are needy, so they make friendships. If somebody is not needy and somebody does not have any fear at all of enemies, then why should one, you know, be attracted to anyone? Think about it. Naveda kaschit bhagavam stikirshitam taveha manasya rinam vidambanam nayasya kaschit dayito stikarhichet dveshyascha yasmin vishamamatir rinam. Kunti Manani is saying the same point there. She's telling, my dear Lord, nobody can favor you. Nobody can cause you harm. Because you are Supreme Personality of Godhead. You have a spiritual body. Nobody can cut you or body or burn your body. You are spiritual completely. You know, Krishna and Balaram, they jumped from, you know, practically 90 miles high mountain. I'll show you the picture. Just a minute. You can show this. See, this is called Pravarshana Mountain. Krishna Balaram are jumping and they didn't get a leg fracture and they did not have to be admitted in an orthopedic section of a hospital to repair their bones. Because they have a Satchidananda Swarupam, spiritual body. So, therefore nobody can harm them. You will never hear anywhere that Krishna was defeated in any battle. Although big people fought with Krishna. Nobody has defeated. So many demons lined up in Vrindavan and Krishna finished all of them effortlessly, simply with his hand and leg and lips and everything, without even using any weapon, without even expanding his eyes very big. So, on one hand, he effortlessly kills the demons. On the other hand, the demons could not even create a scratch on his body. When Krishna caught hold of the neck of Trinavarta and brought him down from the sky to the ground and he fell on a slab and his body got crashed on the slab and, you know, he was finished, all his bones broke to pieces. So Nanda Baba was telling, look at our baby Krishna, his body is like so shining like Neelamani and there is not even a scratch in his body because our child is a very great pious child. And yeah, and on the other hand, the demon died because of his own sinful reactions, like that Nanda Baba was saying. So nobody can harm Krishna. Nobody can favor Krishna. What favor can anybody give? Krishna says, Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam pravartate. Everything emanates from me. All the material and spiritual worlds emanate from me, Krishna says. And also there is nobody greater than me. He says, matta parataram na anyat. Kinchidasti dhananjaya. In that verse he says, you know, I am like the nylon thread which keeps all the planets and universes in proper locations. Krishna says, it's me who sustains all of them. For such a great personality, who can give what to attract him? So he is not to be attracted by any petty thing of this world, because if you give anything from this world, ultimately it belongs to him. It's like going to a very big Sima bulbs company owner along with the tube light. Sir, I have brought a tube light for you. He will laugh at you. He will say, I am producing millions of bulbs. Sir, I am sending them all over the world and they are giving me a tube light. So, therefore, this topic is very important for us. How to attract the all attractive? Krishna himself is called Manohar. Har means to, you know, to attract. Manohar means one who attracts our mind or enchants our mind. Like you hear in the song, no? Bhakti Priti Mala Chandan Tumi Niyo He Niyo Chittanandan. See, the word Chittanandan means Manohar. Chitta. Chittanandan, one who delights our heart. Tumi Niyo He Niyo Chittanandan. Take please Krishna, take delighter of the hearts. Like that he is singing. And then he is saying, so the song is a beautiful song. It's a delighter of the hearts. He delights our heart, but how can we attract him? We get attracted by him. We can go to his temple, we can bow down to him, we can circumambulate him, be fascinated by him. But how to go to his abode? How to gain opportunity to serve him? How to remain in his company eternally? Or how to draw his attention? So these are important questions for us. That is the theme of this talk today. So one very easy way to know how to attract Krishna is by studying the scriptures and hearing from great souls on what attracts Krishna. Generally, when you go to meet some very big man, important man, you want to impress him or you want to please him, you have to carry some gift for him. Then you ask his friends, what will he like very much? He says, oh, he likes Giriraj Sonbabdi. Then you carry Sonbabdi, you know, one pack with you. And you say, sir, I'm coming from Vrindavan, I brought Sonbabdi for you. Then he will open it and put a piece in the mouth and he'll be very delighted. He will say, thank you, you understood my heart. Now tell me whatever you want, I'll give you. So in the same manner, when we go to Krishna, you know, what can we show him or give him which will charm his heart in such a way that he will become favorably disposed towards us and he will glance at us very mercifully. So, Srimati Radharani is called Hara. Hara means one who has stolen the heart of Lord Hari. That's the meaning of the word Hara. Oh really? She has stolen the heart of Krishna. That means Krishna is lost. Like people say, you know, they wear a t-shirt which has a quote behind, no? I lost my heart in Vrindavan. People say, no? Actually, nobody gives their heart to somebody. People only find their hearts lost. Suddenly you say, hey, where is my heart? Oh, that person has taken away. That's how we all find in our life. If you fell in love with somebody, they steal your hearts. They don't ask you for the heart. Isn't it? Therefore, we say, you know, I lost my heart in Vrindavan. We don't say, I went to Vrindavan, gave my heart and came back. No, I lost my heart. So, in the same manner, Krishna is so attractive that we can lose our hearts to him. But how can anyone make Krishna lose his heart to his devotee? And the devotee who is able to do make Krishna lose his heart is Srimati Radharani. Because she is called Madana Mohana Mohini. Krishna is called Madan Mohan. He can attract millions of cupids. Kandarpa Koti Kamaniya Vishesha Shobham. Like that it says. Koti, it says. He can attract crores of cupids, Krishna. But he is in turn attracted to Srimati Radharani's devotion. So, Madana Mohana Mohini, it is said. So, what is there in Srimati Radharani that charms the heart of Krishna? To lose his heart for that great devotee. So, you will find, if you scan through all the scriptures, you will find that Krishna has two qualities And he wants us to match those two qualities by our two qualities. So I will tell you what is Krishna's two qualities and our two qualities. So if we can match it, then we can attract the heart of Krishna. Like for example, just now, till now I have been telling you, Krishna is all attractive. Like that verse says, you know, Sanyasi Chitkarna Jeeva Surya Kirana Sama Shadeshwarya Purna Krishna Hoya Suryopama. This verse says, we are like a Chitkarna Jeeva, a tiny particle of the sunlight, sun, like a sun rays. And Krishna is like the full sun with all the six opulences. So, Shadeshwarya Purna Krishna Hoya Surya Upama. His Upama is with sun, Krishna Surya Sama. Maya Khayanda Karyaha Krishna Tahanai, Maya Radhi Karviseno. So, he is like sun and we are like rays of the sun. We are tiny. We are tiny and he is Vibhu, he is great, we are Anu. So, Krishna is all attractive and we are minutely attractive. So, because we are only minutely attractive, then how can we attract the all attractive? But it is possible. How? So, Krishna has all attractiveness. But what is in us that attracts him is lavalyam or the greed. There is one famous verse. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavitamati kriyatam api kutho vilabhyate tatra lavalyam api ekala mulyam janma koti sukrate na labhyate. Very famous verse. From here only Prabhupada got the name for ISKCON. Prabhupada was singing, what name to give to my society? And then he got the powerful word, Krishna bhava. Krishna rasabhavitamati. Yeah, rasabhavitamati means that devotee whose mind is imbued with the transcendental rasa with Krishna. In any of the rasas, like a friend, or like a parent, or like a lover. If somebody's mind is imbued with the rasa, Krishna bhakti, rasabhavitamati. Rasabhavitamati means transcendently inspired intelligence. It's very easy to remember. You know, IIT. You reverse it. TII. TII is transcendently inspired intelligence. So that is rasabhavitamati. That means the transcendental actually means we are nirguna, beyond the three gunas, vishuddha sattva. And in that inspired intelligence, our intelligence becomes imbued with loving attraction for Krishna's pastimes, childhood pastimes, his boyhood pastimes, his pastimes with Yashoda, Nanda, the gopis, cows, calves, Vrindavan. If somebody's mind becomes imbued, just like we have seen His Grace Dinabandhu Prabhu in Vrindavan, he's always absorbed in narrating the pastimes and relishing the pastimes. For him, it's like eating a feast. To narrate the pastimes of Krishna. So, if our intelligence can become inspired in a similar way, and lavalyam can arise in our heart. Lavalyam actually means greed, transcendental greed, which is called spontaneous love, we call it. So, that is one qualification to attract Krishna. In whichever devotee's heart, Krishna sees that greed to attain him, then Krishna goes running behind that devotee. If the devotee is doing bhajan, Krishna wants to sit and hear. You must have seen the picture of that Billwa Mangal Thakur with blind eyes, carrying a tanpura and he is doing kirtan, calling Krishna's names. And Krishna is deeply inspired simply by hearing that kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. Madanga? Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, रामा हरे 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 कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 राम हरे सो बिरला मंगल ऑल्दो ही वाज ब्लाइंड ही वाज सिंगिंग द होली नेम विद द तानपुरा एंड लॉर्ड कृष्णा केम एंड सैट इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम and heard the kirtan because his heart was filled with greed for Krishna. So when there is greed, transcendental greed, actually mundane greed is condemned in this world. Because you find in this material world, there is so much of mundane greed. Recently I heard in Belgaum, they grow this sugar cane. So one time when they had grown a lot of sugar cane in the field, elephant from the forest came, entered the field and smashed everything to ground level, decimated practically and ate everything. So next time when they made the sugar cane, they made a fence all around. They put the stones like this, and then in between they have barbed wires. They had put that so that elephant can't come inside. Of course, elephant gets enough food in the forest in the form of grasses. He eats a lot in the forest, tons of grass. But then his tongue is long. He also wants to eat sugar cane, you see. Living entities are not satisfied with need because they have greed. So therefore, he again came. He went round and round. He found everywhere it's fenced now. He can't enter inside. He went mad actually. I'm seeing the sugar cane, but I can't eat it. What to do? Then he sat in one place in front of the barbed wire and started moving his body this way, like this. And started smashing the barbed wire down. And actually he could do it successfully. He did like this, and of course the wood and the stone pillars type of thing, and they all fell also. They all bent also like this, and he bent the barbed wire. But while doing it, he got a lot of skin tearing and then bleeding also. Because in this world, sense gratification doesn't come cheaply, very easily. One has to work hard. Along with the pleasure, the pain is mixed in this world. So, then after that he crossed over the barbed wire, which tore some part of his legs and everything. Then he could eat some sugar cane, and then people came and bit him severely, threw stones and everything and drove him out. So, but why I told you this, in this world also, you can see every living entity has greed. Like a fish is swimming in the water eating it has got its own food in the water arranged by Krishna. For every living being has arranged. But fish is not satisfied with basic rice, dal, sabji, chapati. In South India, you have sambar rice, rasam rice, and dahi rice. And sabji, one is not satisfied. One wants pickles. One wants payasam, some additional things. One wants some additional item. Similarly, the fish thinks, oh, here is a piece of meat hanging. So when you go there, he just catches that. And then the fisherman just takes out the meaty bait which he put. He takes out the hook. Then along with that, fish is out of the water. He dies. So if he was satisfied with the need, he would have been happy. But he became greedy. He lost his life. Now that is about the fish or the elephant. Similarly, man is also very greedy for making a lot of money and for enjoying sense gratification. This is the meaning of Hiranya and Kashipu. Hiranya means money, Kashipu means soft bed. So he wants money and sex. This is everything for conditioned souls. So they are greedy for this. Like Ravana was not happy with Mandodari. He wanted to catch the hand of Sita and drag her to Lanka. So he got destroyed. So material greed destroys people, whereas spiritual greed elevates you to back to Godhead. In the path of spiritual life, greed is most welcome. On the other hand, the material greed is very condemned. Therefore, we have to transform the material greed into spiritual greed. So in spiritual life, oftentimes we remain at a level where we do the basic spiritual life, like chanting 16 rounds, following 4 regs, and going to temple once a week or whatever. So there are most people who do that, and then balance time goes on in keeping the body and soul together, maintaining the family, you know, running the business, and firefighting and problem solving on a material platform. And there is not much time for spiritual life. Basic spiritual life is going on for most people. Will that do? Actually, that will not do, because if you do only basic spiritual life, over a period of time, spiritual life can become boring. Spiritual life can become challenging. Spiritual life can, over a period of time, become burdensome. So then how do we go from basic spiritual life to greedy platform of spontaneous love, in which every moment would be meaningful, purposeful, joyful, relishable, and every moment would take us one step closer to Krishna. It will lead to respect for Krishna, admiration for Krishna, appreciation for Krishna, gratitude for Krishna. Every moment, how can it become a very fruitful and valuable moment for us? So there are 3 steps to come to that platform of Laulya. The first step is awakening. Step 1 is awakening. Awakening to what? Like if you look at the world around you, you can see the world is a very active world. You know, the sun is rising, sun is setting, moon is rising, seasons are changing. You know, rains are showering from the clouds, grains are being on the ground, and flowers are laddering the fruit-bearing trees. You know, the ocean has Navaratnas, the mountains have gold and silver and diamond, and also all living entities are running here and there. So it's a very dynamic world, active world. By looking at the world around you, you can easily come to a conclusion that this is a very organized, well-designed world, and there must be a great giant brain behind this gigantic cosmos. There is a big brain which has created this world. That's a great God. I am a very tiny soul, you know, maintaining this small body, which is also like a small universe. And this great universe is maintained by a great God. And also there must be a sambandha between him and me. Otherwise, why is he giving me nice eatables to eat, fruit juices to drink, warmth of the sunlight to protect me? And around the earth, there is a ozonosphere, which protects the living entities on earth from the ultraviolet radiation and all that, from the sun. So that means all loving God has put a protective layer of ozonosphere to protect all of us. So he gives us a motherly touch, fatherly touch. So we can understand there is a sambandha between him and us. Just like a father sends his son to Bangalore to study. In whichever village he may be, he sends money every month for his food, clothing and shelter. Similarly, God has sent us here and he has given us so much nice facilities. Like what the Dwarkavasi said. Bhavayanastvam bhava vishva bhavanah Tvameva matata suhrit patipita Tvam sadgururna paramam cha daivatam Yasyanu vritya kritino babhuvima. They all said, Dwarkavasis, while welcoming Krishna, they said, they are saying, what a beautiful world you have created for us, Krishna. You know, every need of the living entity is taken so nicely, taken such nice care. They said, you are like our mother, you are like our father, you are like our guru, you are our friend, well-wishing friend. You are actually our leader. You are everything for us, they said. And they also said, by becoming your follower, our lives have become so auspicious and so joyful. So this is the first one called awakening. knowing that I exist, knowing that God Krishna exists, and there is a sambandha between the two. Awakening. We should awaken in our life to that. Okay, awakening is not enough. The second step should happen, which is executing duties. For example, if a man marries a woman and says, okay, I am your husband, that's not enough. But what are you doing as a husband? Are you giving her a house? Are you getting a car? Are you giving her saris and ornaments? Are you bringing grocery? Are you having a job which brings a salary and you give her some money to run the family? So your duty is towards the wife. Or if a student says, I have joined an engineering college, and he can't be just sitting at home saying, I have already joined. No, he has to go to college. He has to sit in the class, get the required attendance, and write the tests and exams, earn the degree. So in this way, he has to execute his duties as a student. And a man has to execute his duties as a husband. They have their respective duties. If you say, I am an Indian, oh really? If you say you are an Indian, you identify with the Indian citizenship, then are you giving votes? Are you paying taxes? Do you abide by the laws of the country? All this will be checked. In the same manner, if somebody says, yeah, I am not an atheist, I believe in God. God is very good, very nice. I am very thankful to him. No, sir, that's not enough. What are you doing for him? Some people, if you tell them that you are taking sunlight, you are taking rainwater, you are taking moonlight for making the juices of the vegetables, and you are taking grains from the ground, where are you paying tax for all these things? Like, for example, if you are, people say that, oh, this is all coming from our nature. Yeah, it's coming from nature, but who is arranging it to come from the nature? Maya Adhyakshena Prakriti. Krishna says 9.10 Bhagavad Gita. Nature is working under my direction. For example, you are getting drinking water, corporation water, isn't it? If somebody says, hey, this is coming from that big tank, don't you see, in the middle of our town, from there water is coming, so why to pay? No, that big tank is filled with water by the municipality. You have to pay to the municipality. If you don't pay, then the municipality will cut the water line for you. Similarly, if you don't do yajna for the Lord, then our water supply, food supply, as it says, anavrishti, durbhiksha, karapidita. These things are said in Bhagavatam. Anavrishti means there will be no rains. Durbhiksha means dryness and scarcity. And people will run out of resources in this world. And they will be taxed heavily by the government. And these are Kali Yuga symptoms. So one has to do one's duty towards God. One has to understand that. In fact, Krishna says, if you surrender to me, you don't have to surrender to anybody. Deva Rishir Bhutaptananam Pitranam Na Kinkaro Na Yamrini Charajam Sarvatmanaya Sharanam Sharanyam Gato Mukundam Parihrityakartam. This verse says, we all have debt towards the demigods because they are the ones supplying all these things arranged by Krishna. And then rishis. Now, rishis have given us knowledge, wisdom, even for the common people, the rishis give knowledge how to live the life in this world. So we have debt towards them. They are wise people, learned people, detached people, saintly people, godly people. So they do so much good for the world. We have debt towards them. Rishiran, we call it. So Devaran, Rishiran, all the living entities, like for example, your relatives, your uncle, your aunt, your grandfather, grandmother, your relatives, they have actually given you social support. So you have some responsibility to them also. Your apta, your relatives. And even people living in your society, they have a society gathering meeting. They come together and run the society. So, and they are actually giving you their friendship and giving you sometimes material support also. You have duty towards them. And also other living entities like cows give you milk, donkey gives you luggage carrying, and horses also carry weight and people, isn't it? And camel carries weight also. And dog protects the house. So we have debt towards those animals also. You have debt towards even the soldiers of your country who protect the nation from the enemy forces and all. You have duty for them. And you have duty towards the prime minister and other leaders who are actually protecting the country and making welfare for the country. In this way, you have so many duties in this world. But Krishna says, Sarvatmanaya Sharanam Sharanyam. If you surrender to one personality who is Krishna, it's called one stroke method. You surrender to him, then he says, all the other debts I will take care, Krishna is saying. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami. You become free from the sin that will arise from not fulfilling these debts. I will take care of that because they are all under me. It's like watering the root of the tree, the whole tree gets nourished. Putting food in the belly, then the whole body gets nourished. Similarly, serve Krishna, then all duties and debts will be finished. Like that Krishna says. So therefore, this is the second step. The first step I told you is awakening. Second step is executing duties, our duties. So we have to, therefore, we have taken shelter of the Vaishnava spiritual master. And we are chanting 16 rounds, following four regulative principles, coming to the temple and reading Prabhupada's books. And also making an effort to lead a very pure life. With living in the company of devotees, avoiding non-devotee association, and praying to Lord, bowing down to Lord, circumambulating the Lord, all that we are doing. 64 regulative principles also. Even the Rupa Goswami. So all this is executing duties. But we are doing these duties out of duty, not out of love. Because Guru has told me to do, so I do. Not that my heart is longing to do these things. Oftentimes, we get up in the morning because I am supposed to get up. We chant 16 rounds because I am supposed to complete 16 rounds. I have taken initiation like that. So, therefore, you have to come to the third step. The third step is exchanging love. That's the third step. Really? How do we do that? In the second step, if you execute the duties on a regular basis, with a little longing, that little longing in the Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti stage is what that turns into Raganuga eventually. Mami Chaptum Dhananjaya, Krishna says that. He says, Mayeva Mana Adatsva Mayi Buddhim Niveshaya Nivasishyasi Mayeva Atavurdvam Nasamshayaha Atachittam Samadatum Nashaknoshi Mayi Stiram Abhyasa Yogena Tato Mami Chaptum Dhananjaya. Abhyasa Yoga means 16 rounds chanting and 4 regs. This is 12th chapter. You'll read 7, 8, 9 verses. 12.789 Bhagavad Gita. So, Krishna says that do the Abhyasa Yoga, but not only Abhyasa Yoga of 16 rounds every day. Mam Ichchaptum Dhananjaya. Have an Ichcha for attaining me, he says. That's very important. Because that little Ichcha, like a spark of fire, will become a flagrant fire, big fire, and that is greed. That's where one should know the secret is here. Every one of us have that little spark. Otherwise, we would have never got initiated. We would have never been a follower of Prabhupada's movement. We have some fire, but that fire is small right now. We should act in such a way that the fire will grow very big. Not that we act in such a way that we will douse the fire. So in the Bhagavad Gita, Sridhar Swami, in his commentary to one of the verses, 6.37, he told why a jiva becomes yoga brashta. Yoga Brashta means the one who falls down in his spiritual path. And he told two reasons, he said. He said, Yatna Shaitilyam, he said. Yatna means endeavor. Shaitilyam means weakness. Making it Dila. Dila means loose. Not intense endeavor, but you know, reducing the spiritual endeavors. Yatna Shaitilyam, he says. I'll read the commentary of Sridhar Swami. Can see that. This is the verse. The verse is 37th verse 6th chapter. Ayati shraddha yopeto yoga achalita manasaha aprapya yoga samsiddhim kangatim krishna gacchati. Like that. Yopeto yoga achalita manasaha means while practicing spiritual life, Krishna, yoga achalita manasaha, you're living any day, goes away from spiritual life. Sometimes. Why? Aprapya yoga samsiddhim. Not attaining perfection in Krishna consciousness. Kankatim Krishna kachati. What happens to him? So, in that commentary, Sridhar Swami is saying, Prathamam shraddhayopeta eva yoge pravritto natu mithyacharataya. He's saying, you know, those people who earlier had a Shraddha, faith. You know what is Shraddha? Shraddha also is defined by Sridhar Swami in another place. Shraddha means faith in the path of goodness. That is the Shraddha. That means life of mode of goodness. You have faith in it. Not in life and mode of passion or ignorance. The Shraddha means having faith in the life of goodness. So, those people who had Shraddha before, and they were engaged in Krishna consciousness, but sometimes they leave. They don't leave because of mithyachara or something. Not that they did some blunder in spiritual life. Not because of that, he says. Then why they leave? But they became little careless or little bit, like Bharat Maharaj, for example. He became compassionate to a deer and his practice of spiritual life became little weak.
Parantu ayate na samyak yatate shithilabhyasa ityartha.
Yatate shithilabhyasa, he's saying. The endeavor becomes shithila, he's saying. So, like you all know, the rocket, it has to go at a speed of, you know, 11 kilometers per second. Like that it should go. It has an intensity. If that intensity is not there, it cannot go out of the gravitational pull of the earth. So it has to go with a certain intensity. Zoom, like that. Then only it can go out. If it becomes yatate shitila, it becomes a little dila and it goes, then it will take a U-turn and come back. Same thing with the Krishna conscious devotees. We have to be like a bullet in spiritual life. Very serious practice. Zoom, like that we go back to Godhead. You don't come back. So therefore he is saying, yatate shitilabhyasa ityartha tatha yoga chalitam manasam vishaya pravanam chittam yasya manda vairagya ityartha. This is another word he is using. Chittam yasya manda vairagya ityartha. He is saying that, vishaya pravanam chittam yasya manasam vishaya pravanam chittam yasya. That means in the mind, one becomes allured by material desires and material allurements in the mind, and because of that, manda vairagya ityartha. His vairagya or detachment becomes very manda. Just like you have firewood, you know, while putting in the furnace, say you sprinkle some water in it, and then you put it in the furnace. When you start the fire, smoke will come. Then there is no intense fire. Then you can't cook sabji or something nicely. So you need dry firewood. You don't need wet firewood. So Prabhupada compared the word, you know, shitala, manda vairagya, to firewood sprinkled with water. And strong vairagya means the firewood without water. Like that.
Evam abhyasa vairagya shaitilyat. Yogasya samsiddhim phalam jnanam aprapya kam gatim prapnote.
See, that's what he is saying. Evam abhyasa vairagya shaitilyad. When vairagya becomes shitila.
And yogasya samsiddhim phalam jnanam aprapya. One is not able to attain the perfection of the fruit of Krishna conscious practice. Like that he says.
So, this is one of the reasons why we don't go from stage 2 to stage. First I told you is awakening. There's a second step to God is executing duties, and third one is exchanging love. To go from executing duties to exchanging love, we should not make our yatna or the endeavors shithila. We should not do, and our vairagya should not be manda. We should take care. That means detachment from all the material sense enjoyment. One has to be very careful not to get carried away by the material world with its glitter and glamour. If you are going to mix sense gratification in our spiritual life, then Prabhupada said we may have to go to heaven. And then finish our material desires, then prapya punya kritam lokan ushitva shashvati sama shuchi nam shimatam gehe. We will have to be born in the house of Brahmana or Vaishya. But if we finish our material desires now, by not making our endeavors shithil,
and not making our vairagya manda, then we can come to the platform of exchanging love with the Lord. That's a secret actually. Exchanging love platform means spontaneous platform. Just like you may have experience that sometimes you start the motor, sound is coming, but there is no water lifted up to the motor. Motor is also on. No water. Why? The reason is there is an air gap. And that air gap is our lack of Krishna consciousness in our heart also. Many times you are chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, but there is no Krishna consciousness coming because mind is filled with so many thoughts and so many different things. So many times, two things, sleep and mind wandering. That doesn't allow us to advance. But then we come to the stage of 16 rounds, 4 regs, and then take shelter of a guru. So guru is the one who does priming. Priming means take some 1 or 2 mug of water and pour it in the air gap. When the air gap gets filled, immediately water will rise. Gubuk, like that. You can see in villages, tata, 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 so much water comes out of the tap. Because once the priming is done, then there is no air gap. And water comes out very well. In the same manner, guru puts some little Krishna consciousness into our heart. By his own example. Apani acharya kori sabare sikai. And by seeing his sweet spiritual example, we get inspired to get rid of that gap of Krishna consciousness. And then he fills it up. Then our spontaneous love emerges from the heart. Then we become serious devotees. We can exchange love in that platform of spontaneous love. Then the lavalyam can increase more and more and more. So this is one thing. Krishna is all attractive, so we should have lavalyam. And the second thing is, Krishna is compassionate. He is very compassionate. Like there is one verse which says, Rasika Shekhara Krishna Parama Karuna Yeidu Yihetu Haite Premara Vudgama. This is from Chaitanya Charitamrita. It says, Rasika Shekhara Krishna means all attractive Krishna. Parama Karuna. He is also very greatly merciful. Yeidu Yihetu Haite. These are the two hetu which attracts the devotees to Krishna. Either compassion of Krishna attracts you, or the attractive features of sportive Krishna, playful Krishna, you know, who performs beautiful pastimes, that attracts you. You may be charmed by his naughty nature, sweet nature, or you may be attracted by his compassion. So he gives these two things to us. And what two things we have to give? One I told you is lavalyam, greed, which I explained till now. And the second one is yatate chatato bhuya. Yatate means you have to endeavor. Because he is giving karuna, like karuna is coming down like a rope inside a well. I am in the well, what I should do? I should extend my hand and catch the rope of mercy. And then with the rope he will pull me out. And Krishna says that, Machitta sarvadurgani mat prasadat tarishyasi atachetva mahankaram nashroshyasi vinangshyasi. He says, Arjuna, if you take shelter of me, you catch the rope of mercy that I am giving you, I will deliver you from this world, nothing to worry. Mat prasadat tarishyasi. By my mercy, you will be liberated, don't worry, he says. Like he says, Teshamaham samuddarta mrityu samsara sagarat bhavami nachirat partham ayyaveshita chetasam. Like that he says, Teshamaham samuddarta. I will deliver Arjuna, my devotees. So in this way, he is very merciful to deliver us. So is it not our duty to endeavor? Like I sow the seed, Lord will give the reins. I give the interview and the panel will choose me for the job. And I study the subjects well and give the exam and teacher will give me marks. But if I don't put my endeavors, how do we expect to become Krishna conscious? Like Krishna is telling Arjuna, I will ride your chariot, Arjuna. I will become Parthsarathi, but I don't expect you to go to sleep behind. You should take your Gandiva bow and fight the battle. So we should do our part, endeavor. And that endeavor, how we should do? That also Krishna specified in Bhagavad Gita. Repeatedly, in many, many places, our endeavor should be continuous, non-stop. 24/7 he wants us to be Krishna conscious. For example, Ananya Chetaha Satatam Yomam Smarati Nityashah Tasyaham Sulabha Partha Nitya Yuktasya Yoginah. See, Ananya Chetaha, without any other Vishaya for you. You have to focus on me in a one-pointed way, Krishna says. Satatam, He says, always. And then, Yomam Smarati Nityashaha, again, daily, he says. And then he is saying, Tasyaham, such a person, so labha partha, very easily he will get me. He can attract me very easily, he says. Why? Nitya Yuktasya Yogina, he is always engaged in my devotion service. That means, you know, if you are always engaged in Krishna consciousness, Prabhupada said, always means what? A grihastha has to take care of children, take care of wife and mother and father. They also have to go to office. They have some duties to do. Okay, they can do all these things. They have to go to the market and fetch some grocery and bring and everything. But one should make one's Krishna consciousness so serious that all these activities will become imbued with Krishna consciousness. For example, you're going to marketplace. You will not go empty hand. You will carry some recording with you on the way. Nowadays, everybody, boys, girls, they are hearing. You can see them with a earphone, the train, bus, everywhere. See how continuously they are, you know, giving attention to sense gratification. You see, like that we have to give attention to Krishna. Krishna says, just as the karmis are attentive to sense gratification, we have to be attentive for Krishna. That's the meaning. Then we are really endeavoring. We don't consider Krishna consciousness as a side thing. For us, Krishna becomes the main thing. And we also do the other things as side things. For us, the main thing is Krishna consciousness. I don't have to exaggerate more on that. You all will understand. As soon as there is a little time, devotee will read Prabhupada's books, hear the lectures, go to the temple, do some services. Even in office, a devotee will think how to connect people to Krishna. Marathon is coming, how to give books to them. You know, how to bring them to our temple. In our temple, there is some children classes going on online. Let me connect my colleagues' children to the course, bring them to Krishna's association. So in this way, we have to always be thinking. So these two things, if we do, our endeavor and our greed can very easily attract Krishna. So I'm going to show you one, you can show the PowerPoint. You can see Krishna read Rukmini's message brought by the Brahmana, as you see in the picture. When Krishna, as soon as he saw Rukmini's letter as Dwarakadish, you see, she had written this.
Shrutva gunan bhuvana sundara shrinmatam te nirvishya karna vivarair haratonga tapam rupam drisham drishimatam akhilartha labham twayachyuta vishati chittam apatrapam me.
She said that, my dear Krishna, three things happened to her when she heard Krishna katha. She is saying, haratonga tapam. All my miseries of body and mind were finished, Krishna, because you consumed my consciousness fully. Like that she is telling, haratonga tapam. And then he's saying, Rupam Trisham Drishimatam, Akhilartha Labham, Tvayi Achyuta Avishati, Chittam. Avishati Chittam, she's saying. My Chitta became Avishta, means completely focused on you. My heart is stolen by you, she's telling. And Apatrapam me, I have lost all my sankoch now in approaching you. You know, generally in the Vedic times, no unmarried girl will consider writing a letter to somebody without the permission of father and mother, but I am writing to you. She said that because you are my Lord and I don't want anybody else in my life as my husband, I want you only. So I am shamelessly writing to you, she said. In the same manner, a devotee should experience these three things if you do those two things. If you are endeavoring enough and you are sufficiently greedy in spiritual life, these symptoms will come in us. What are the first symptoms? She said, haratonga tapam. You will not care for bodily miseries, mental miseries. You will throw them far away and fully be Krishna conscious. They will not disturb you. Because you have no time for them. Your time is only for Krishna. And the second thing, she says, chittam avishtam. Avishta chittam means our chitta, our heart will be stolen by Krishna. And that will become our main activity. And thirdly, she is saying, apatrapam me. Even though relatives, friends, society, people will criticize you, ridicule you, mock at you, shout at you and try to drag you back to Maya, they will find themselves helpless because you have become mad in Krishna consciousness. So that means you have come to the third stage of exchanging love with the Lord. He has become everything for you. And then what Krishna says for that, after he saw her attracted to these things of Krishna, he says, as Rukmini's mind is fixed on me, my mind is fixed on her. I can't even sleep at night. This Rukmi, her brother, out of envy, forbade our marriage. But Krishna says, Brahmana, don't worry. Tell her that I will come immediately to Dwaraka to fetch her, take her, because she is such a pure devotee of mine. In a one-pointed way, she is worshipping me, she will definitely attain me. So, and then Rukmini is waiting. Alas, my wedding is to take place when the night ends. How unlucky I am. Lotus-eyed Krishna does not come. I don't know why. And then she thought, maybe I am not qualified. Therefore, in the last part of her letter, she wrote, Yasyangri pankajarajas napanam mahanto vanchanti umapatiribatmatamopahatyai yariham bujaksha nalabhe yabhavat prasadam chahyam asun pratakrashan shatajanma visyat. Oh, my dear Krishna, even the great personalities like Shiva and Brahma take the dust of your lotus feet and apply on their heads to eradicate their ignorance. So, considering that such great souls are your devotees, I think I am too insignificant, little girl, to ask you to accept me as your wife. I think it's a shame on me because I have no adhikar to make such demand of you. Please tell me, O lotus-eyed one, in case I am not qualified, order me for another 100 lifetimes. I will give my body, mind, words in your devotional service. After which, if you consider me eligible, you may accept me. But please do not reject me. If you reject me and ask me to marry Shishupal, you will not find me alive. Like that she is telling. Such is the intensity of her devotion. See, she is waiting and the Brahmana is coming. Rukmini, whose mind had been stolen by Krishna, closed her tear-filled eyes, remembering that there was still time. And then she saw that purest of the learned Brahmana was coming. So simply by looking at the Brahmana, she could immediately understand. Brahmana was cheerful. By his walk and the gesture and the confidence, immediately Rukmini understood that Krishna has accepted my letter and he will accept me as his wedded wife and I will not be rejected. Krishna Bhagavan ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, thank you very much. You ask any questions they have? 5 minutes, I can take questions. Here there's a question. Prabhu, can I answer this question? Is there 5 minutes time for the question?
Yes, Prabhuji. Okay. We have more time for that.
Yes, Prabhuji. So, here is one question. When Sankarshan Priya Prabhu has asked a question. When we fully surrender to Krishna, all our debts to all devas, rishis, pitrus, animals and other living beings will be taken care of. What is the condition of those who are not fully surrendered? How can we fully surrender? Okay, that's the first question. So, actually, as I told you, that as we begin our spiritual life, we have many priorities in our life. Surrendering fully means Krishna becomes your first priority. And other things you don't neglect, you do. For example, you don't neglect wife and children. You don't neglect mother and father. You don't neglect the profession. But you will see that all those things become imbued with Krishna consciousness. One example I'll tell you. If a boy loves a girl, do you think he never does his studies, never passes exams, he never gets a job, he never eats, never sleeps? Do you think that? He does all those things. But he cannot forget her. She is always in his mind. As soon as there is a little opportunity, he tries to connect with her everywhere. Same way Krishna's devotee. That means you are fully surrendered. What as devotees we do, on the day of Shraddha, some people perform all the Riti Rivaji Puja and everything. But other devotees call the devotees to their home and do kirtans for their forefathers. They offer prasad to Krishna and that Krishna prasad they offer to Vaishnavas. And do kirtan on behalf of that grandfather, grandmother who have passed away. We do the Shraddha. And that is the way we do. That is good enough in Krishna consciousness. That means your faith has come, that simply by chanting the holy name, I will take care of all my forefathers. And all the devatas are dancing when you are singing the holy name. They are very happy that you are engaged. So we have to keep on increasing our intensity in spiritual life. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, there is some question. 1 minute. Okay, second question was, what activities will douse the little spark of love for Krishna? Two things. One is the yatna shaitilyam, which means we become carried away by material allurements. Like for example, he became carried away by the compassion to the deer. or Ajamila became carried away by a lusty sight. That is one thing. And another thing is the Vaishnava Aparadha. So sins and offenses, these are the two things that distract us. And yeah, can you post which one? Okay. Here is the question. Okay, I can post the quality, 8 qualities of Krishna. I'll post this PPT to Prabhuji and then Prabhuji will give you. You can see that, okay? I will do that, yeah. Here, I wish to know again about Bharat Maharaj. What wrong did he do? He just had a little concern about deer's welfare, which is human compassion. Satyaraj was asking. Oh, that's perfect. Actually, compassion is natural for any Vaishnava. But what happened with him, while showing compassion to the deer, you know, he was chanting Hare Krishna. I mean, he was also doing yajna. But the deer grew up a little bit. So he should have left the deer with other deers. Because deers are the same family, you know, birds are the same feather flock together. But instead of doing that, he slowly became attached to the deer. So he kept the deer growing in his own ashrama. He carried it to the forest, thinking that tiger or other animals may attack him in the hermitage. Then he fed grass with his own hands. He kept the deer on the lap. While sleeping at night, he kept the deer on his chest. Even while performing yajna, while offering the ahuti, you know, he's offering ahuti with one hand and looking at the deer and smiling. That means his mind became imbued with deer consciousness. That was a mistake. Showing compassion was not a mistake. He could have shown little compassion. When the deer grew up, he should leave it with other deers and focus on your own spiritual life. Similarly, we also sometimes, in the name of doing some welfare activity, we get diverted from Krishna consciousness. We diverted away, which is not correct. Yeah. Here there's a question. Jagrat Kumar Prabhu is asking. At what point should we draw a line between need and greed? Actually, if we don't know that we are going into greedy zone, we need good Vaishnava friends who can tell us. Like one gentleman was telling me, Prabhuji, this is my devotee friends always call me to temple on Sunday, but I take my daughter for Bharatanatyam. I take my son for, you know, swimming classes, you know. You know, I take my another son for Sanskrit classes. So I am busy all day Sunday. How can I come to temple? But then somebody told him, but you got initiated last year. That's all right, Prabhu. You know, I already told you I'm very busy, but you all got me initiated. You know, and then they told him, but you are not chanting on your beads. No? But at least I'm chanting in counter, Prabhu. At least 8 rounds in counter, 8 rounds in mala I'm doing. So in this way, there are people who have too many other priorities in life. That means they are too greedy in material life. So in case he wants to go for all these things, you should tell the children and other teachers that, you know, I can only send my children in second part of the day. First part of the day, I will go to ISKCON temple. Till morning, 1 o'clock or something, I'll be in ISKCON. Then between 1 and night, 9 o'clock, I can bring my children and all that. Similarly, chanting, for that night, you have to sleep early and rise early in the morning and finish all the 16 rounds. So in this way, he has to put a line clearly. If we don't draw a line between need and greed, we will get carried away like the current. Like in Harkipodi and Haridwar, if we don't catch hold of the chain, you know, the Ganga Pravah is so fast, she will just carry your head. Like that, the greed of the material world will carry us. We have to be very careful. Yeah. And, yeah, Deepa Mataji is asking, what is the difference between installed and uninstalled deity? Especially with respect to home deities. Yeah. Home deities, generally we don't install, we only welcome them. Welcome means what? Like some Vaishnava devotees come to home, they do kirtan, they do abhishek, and then you dress them well and decorate them and offer them bhoga. And that's how the worship starts. So the well-wishing Vaishnavas come to your home, they worship the deity, do sankirtan, and give a class, and then they accept prasadam. So the Lord is agreeing to come to your house and accept your worship. So we use the word welcome means what? Lord is there now, but if we don't take good care of them, they will go away. They'll go away means the deity may be there, only the deity murti may be there, but the Lord may not be available for us. If the Lord has to actually be in spirit and letter alive there, then we have to actually dress him, decorate him, put up festivals for him, you know, sing his glories, do kirtans, everything. Yeah. And Ashwath Narayan Prabhu is asking, Prabhu, please explain once again two reasons why devotees fall from Krishna consciousness. Sins and offenses. These are two reasons. Yeah. And which sections of Bhagavatam give details about how even Krishna has feelings as a person? Oh, many sections. Actually, you can begin from the first canto. You can go to the first canto, 7th chapter. Krishna is Parthasarathi of Arjuna and Ashwatthama pastime. You can see that. Then you can go to the 10th chapter, 10th and 11th. Krishna leaving Hastinapur and entering Dwaraka. Full of feelings, those chapters you will see. Even in the first canto, you have so much. In 10th canto, if you like these days, I am speaking on demons in Vrindavan Leela. You can see how Krishna is so close to his associates. So many demons he kills and protects his devotees. 10th canto is full of that. But you can go from canto to canto. Canto 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Yeah, Vrinda Priti Mataji is asking, I need this class recording. Thank you very much. Okay. I can arrange for this. No problem. We'll give you. So I have answered all the questions. So thank you all very much. So Prabhu, very kind of you for the opportunity to Narahara Chaitanya Prabhu and all other committee members of ICC for giving me the opportunity to remember Krishna's glories and also, you know, remind myself of these important teachings which I read and I learn, often I forget, but by telling other people it helps me to remember myself. So thank you all very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.
Haribol.
Haribol.
Hare Krishna Prabhupada.
Go ahead Prabhupada.
Thank you, Prabhu.
There is one question there.
Tell me.
Krishna Prabhu, can you hear me? About the Rukmini pastime, when Jarasandha and Krishna were in the battlefield or fighting, that time he leaves the battlefield because he received a, Krishna Prabhupada says he had received a letter from Rukmini. And so he left the battlefield. Can you just clarify a little on the pastime? Is it our sampradaya that clarifies this point? Or when did he receive the letter and why did he decide to address it during when he was in the fight with Jarasandha?
Yeah, actually, he received the letter by the Brahmana who was waiting there for Krishna. And Krishna heard the news which came to him through someone. And then he thought that if he continues the battle here, then the Brahmana will be delayed. And then Rukmini will be married to Shishupal. And therefore, he considered it very important. And this goes to show, just for the sake of one pure devotee, Rukmini, how he was ready to forego the whole battle and even get the name Ranchod Rai. You know? Because when you do Ranchod for a Kshatriya, it's a very shameful thing. But Krishna didn't mind that. Let people call me Ranchod, one who left the battle and ran away. I don't mind, but I have to protect Rukmini. So that is also the significance of this pastime. Is it all right?
Hare Krishna Prabhu,
Dandavat Pranam. Is it an explanation of another
Sampradaya? Somebody was saying something?
Is this explanation given only in our Sampradaya or other Sampradayas also have this explanation? That's the tradition to the question.
Oh, actually, this I definitely have read it, but I have to check it. It may be in the commentary of the Acharyas. See, when Acharyas give such commentaries, they also read Padma Purana, they read Vishnu Purana. They take the same pastime from various Puranas from where they extract the information. I also have to find out. I definitely read what I told you now, but I can check and tell Suvanagarepu, I can send you the reference where I read it.
Thank you, Guruji.
Yeah, thank you. So thank you very much. Hari Bol. Shri Prabhupada ki jai.